Good evening. A warm welcome to you all for this third and final presentation in our fall term lecture series on slow architecture. For those of you who have not attended the two previous lectures, well, first of all, shame on you. But secondly, let me briefly repeat what is meant by slow architecture and why it is being featured in our lectures this term. In our contemporary society, architecture tends to be immersed in a visual culture saturated by instant gratification. The experience and success of a project is encapsulated by one iconic image and how many likes it solicits. At our School of Architecture, we are committed to the methodical process of design, research, and practice, where the focus is less on what's first, but rather on what lasts. In this regard, arguably the leading historical example of slow architecture is the work of the world-renowned Catalan architect Antoni Gaudí. Seven of his masterpieces have been listed as UNESCO World Heritage Sites, including the Parc Güell, Casamila, Casabatlo, and the not yet completed masterpiece Sagrada Familia, still under construction for 135 years. And the most visited monument in all of Spain. By way of comparison, the Florence Cathedral required 140 years to be completed, so no rush. They spent most of their time trying to figure out how to span the dome roof of unprecedented dimension until Brunelleschi came along with a design solution. Therefore, it is fair to say that until relatively recent modern times, all public or institutional buildings that you study in your history of architecture were the result of slow architecture, built to last and inspire for centuries. In the example of Gaudí, his was a highly eclectic personal style which integrated architecture with the design of landscape, sculptures, and various decorative arts. His root was rooted in Catalan heritage, as well as modern technology. Apparently, in what I did not know myself, and will be explained by our guest speakers this evening, was that Gaudí was very much influenced by Chinese art, design, and culture. This evening, by courtesy of a collaboration for a joint Christmas-themed exhibit this weekend between the Gaudí Exhibition Center in Barcelona and the Telford Plaza in Calum Bay. It is our honor to welcome two leading experts on Gaudí visiting Hong Kong from Barcelona. The second speaker, she's just arriving from the airport, is Ms. Maria Massagué, Managing Director of the Gaudí Exhibition Center, which aims to promote the life and work of Antoni Gaudí by organizing conferences and exhibitions around the world. Professor Pere Jordi Figuerola Roger is a historian and museologist. He holds the Antoni Gaudí Chair of the University of Barcelona. He is a founder of the Gaudí Research Institute as well as the biennial Gaudí World Congress. He has taught postgraduate courses on cultural heritage didactics and was a curator at the Diocesan Museum of Barcelona for almost 40 years while coordinating or writing over 200 collections and publications. Professor Ángel Grau Ortega will kindly provide the English translation for tonight's presentations. Would you join me to extend a warm welcome to our visitors from Barcelona?
Hello, my English is not very good. I prefer to use my company, my friend. Ustedes van a ver un video sobre lo que hacemos en Barcelona sobre las investigaciones de Gaudí.
You're going to see a video where they showcases the kind of research they do on Gaudí in Barcelona. Thank you.
el congreso que hicimos en Shanghai el año pasado sobre lo.
This is last year's conference in Shanghai.
El año que viene haremos otro en Beijing y quizás también en Hong Kong y
Shanghai. Next year there will be another one in Beijing and hopefully also in Hong Kong and Shanghai.
Bueno, vamos a empezar.
So let's begin.
Agradezco sobre todo la presencia del señor director de la universidad y de
thank you very much for all your
profesores, alumnos y estudiantes.
Professors, students.
Vamos a hablar sobre un genio universal.
We're going to talk about a universal genius.
A lo largo de la humanidad. Se han dado muchos pocos genios universales.
In the history of mankind, there have been just a few universal geniuses.
Einstein,
Leonardo da Vinci,
Michelangelo. Porque muchos de estos genios nunca llegan a desarrollar su inventiva en la época.
Many of these geniuses do not really manage in the very end to develop their invention in full.
Y esta gente que tiene un don innato.
And these people who have this innate gift.
El 99,9 de las veces acaba en un manicomio.
99.9 of the times they end up in a hospital, the mentally handicapped.
Porque no puede expresar sus ideas del futuro a la gente de su época.
Because they are not able to explain their futuristic ideas to the people.
En concreto, Gaudí está declarado genio universal por la UNESCO y aquí vemos los siete edificios.
In particular, Antoni Gaudí has been well acknowledged as a genius by the UNESCO. These seven buildings have been awarded a UNESCO World Heritage.
Aquí vemos a un joven Gaudí en 1878.
In the middle of the picture you can see Jean Gaudí in 1878.
Esto es el taller del carpintero de la gente rica de la burguesía catalana.
This is the workshop of a carpenter who used to work for the bourgeoisie in Catalonia.
Que ya descubrió cuando Gaudí era joven que era un genio y por eso lo pone en medio de la foto.
And he had realized when Gaudí was already so young, he had realized that he was a genius, so he's basically been placed in the middle of the picture.
¿Qué es lo que diferencia Gaudí de los demás genios y arquitectos del mundo?
What makes Gaudí a different from the rest of the genius and from architects in the world?
Se planteó una idea muy sencilla.
He started from a very simple idea, a simple conception.
La naturaleza que ha llegado a nuestros días, el ser humano, ha evolucionado durante millones de años.
Nature and humankind has evolved over millions of years.
Y lo que ha llegado hasta nuestros días, nosotros mismos, somos lo más perfecto de la.
And what we have received at the very end, we have us, which are the end of this evolutionary process, the most perfected.
Solo hay que copiar la naturaleza y trasladarla a la arquitectura, al diseño.
So you just need to copy nature and translate that into architecture and design.
La idea es fácil, pero hacerlo es difícil.
Well, the basic idea seems quite simple, but to be able to realize that, to achieve this, is very, very complex.
Pasar de una ola a una obra arquitectónica, que ahora es patrimonio mundial, es muy difícil.
To translate a wave into architectural concept that is now World Heritage is a very difficult enterprise.
Esto es otra obra de Gaudí, la Casa Batlló, que es motivo de la exposición que se hace en Hong Kong.
This is part of Casa Batlló, which is now a part of the exhibition that is taking place in Delft Plaza in Hong Kong.
Esto es naturaleza.
This is nature.
And this is Gaudí.
And this is Gaudí.
Esto es un esqueleto de una serpiente.
This is the skeleton, the bone, the spine bone of a snake.
esto es el interior de un edificio de Gaudí.
And this is the inside of a Gaudí building.
Esto es un bosque.
This is a forest.
Y esto es el interior de la Sagrada Familia.
And this is the inside of the Sagrada Familia in Barcelona.
Esto hoy en día se llama biomimética.
Well, we call this biomimesis or biomimetics.
Y como hemos dicho antes, es muy difícil trasladar la naturaleza a las obras de ahora y del futuro.
And as I have stressed before, it's very, very complicated to translate nature into our present and future architectural works. Pero
realmente es el futuro. Estamos copiando algo perfecto que durante millones de años ha evolucionado.
In fact, we are copying something that is perfect that has evolved for millions of years into art.
En dos universidades médicas americanas están estudiando Gaudí por eso.
Two medical schools in the U.S. are currently researching on Gaudí because of this very reason.
¿Cómo trasladar la resistencia de los huesos del cuerpo humano a la arquitectura, al diseño, a la ingeniería naval?
How to translate the resistance of human bones into architecture, into naval engineering?
Esto es un edificio de Gaudí que representa las olas del mar.
This building of Gaudí represents the waves of the sea.
Estos son los grandes arquitectos contemporáneos. Esto es Frank Gehry, el autor del Guggenheim.
And this is Frank Gehry, the author of the Guggenheim.
Pensemos que antes de Gaudí todos los edificios eran rectos, cuadrados.
You have to consider that before Gaudí all the buildings were straight and square.
Gaudí empezó a crear una arquitectura nueva siempre basada en formas curvas.
And Gaudí started a new form of architecture based on curves.
¿Por qué? Porque son la naturaleza ha probado que las curvas son las más resistentes.
Why? Because nature has proven that curves are far more resistant.
Y además son las más bellas.
And furthermore, they are more beautiful.
Esto, en algunos congresos, un compañero mío aparece con un bote de patatas fritas Pringles.
Well, one of his colleagues, when he goes to a conference, he usually shows up with a Pringle potato chips box.
Para demostrar
to prove that
cómo que hace una patata cruda cuando la metes contra un agente agresor, el aceite hirviendo.
Well, basically to prove what is the result when you take a raw potato chip and you put it into a very aggressive environment, which is boiling oil.
Se dobla para hacer la máxima resistencia
basically
al agresor.
Bends to create the utmost resistance to this.
Esto es tan sencillo, es lo que ha dado origen los últimos 150 años en Gaudí a crear nuevas arquitecturas, nuevos diseños de instrumentos.
And this has led to a new form of architecture, new designs of tools, etc.
Esto es el Himalaya Center que está en Shanghai del arquitecto japonés Aretei Sasaki.
This is the Himalaya Center in Shanghai of Japanese architect Sasaki.
Está copiado del edificio que hemos visto antes, ¿no?
Which is inspired in the building we saw before.
Esto es la Sagrada Familia.
This is the Sagrada Familia in Barcelona.
Y estos son los, esto es Frank Gehry, es Norman Foster en Londres, el Gerting.
This is Norman Foster in London, the Gerting.
Y esto es la torre, una torre que hay en Barcelona de Jean Nouvel, un arquitecto.
And this is Jean Nouvel's tower in Barcelona.
Gaudí ya imaginó hace 150 años que estos edificios parabólicos, curvilíneos.
Gaudí already imagined 150 years ago that these parabolic buildings with curves
eran los que realmente eran los más baratos porque eran aerodinámicos.
Were cheaper than traditional buildings because they were aerodynamical.
Los estudios de Gaudí de aerodinámica y geodesia.
The aerodynamics and geodesic studies done by Gaudí.
Hace más de 50 años que se estudian en centros de investigación aeronáutica de Rusia, Estados Unidos y de Japón.
Have been studied in centers for aeronautical engineering in places like Russia, the United States, or Japan.
Por ejemplo, esto que hemos visto antes es una puerta de Gaudí inspirada en células.
This is a gate inspired in cells.
Que es el origen de la naturaleza son las células,
¿no? Which is of course the origin of nature.
Y esto es Zaha Hadid, una arquitecta iraquino-británica que murió hace 2 años.
This is Hadid's work, the Iraqi, British-Iraqi architect who passed away.
Es un proyecto copiado de esta arquitectura orgánica de Gaudí
again,
para Ullate.
Inspired in Gaudí's organic architecture for Ullate.
Esto es un edificio de Gaudí que está en Barcelona, cerca del mar.
This is a Gaudí building in Barcelona, near the sea.
Y esto es uno de los seguidores más importantes de Gaudí, Santiago Calatrava.
And this is Santiago Calatrava, one of Gaudí's most important followers.
Esto es la estación central donde estaban las Torres Gemelas destruidas en 2011.
This is the central station where the Twin Towers in New York used to be.
Sin Gaudí, esta arquitectura no existiría.
Without Gaudí, this kind of architecture wouldn't have existed.
¿Por qué? Una de las cosas que se estudia en Rusia, en el Centro Aeroespacial de Rusia, es la geodesia.
One of the things that is being studied in an aerospatial center in Russia is geodesia, geodesics.
Como deben saber ustedes, este es el estudio matemático de las formas curvas.
The mathematical study of curves.
Y esto antes de Gaudí no existía, no se estudiaban las formas irregulares porque nadie construía.
These kind of irregular shapes were not studied before Gaudí because people wouldn't be able to build them.
La Sagrada Familia de Barcelona se está diseñando en el Centro Aeroespacial de Melbourne, en Australia.
The Sagrada Familia de Barcelona is now being designed in the Aerospatial Center in Melbourne, in Australia.
Porque es muy difícil las formas que no son regulares calcular su resistencia al viento, su resistencia a los elementos.
Because in the case of irregular forms, it's very hard to calculate the resistance to wind or when compared to regular shapes.
También Gaudí es importante por el método.
Gaudí is also important and significant because of the method he employed.
Hay un famoso cocinero español que dicen que es el mejor del mundo, se llama Ferran Adrià.
There is a famous Spanish chef, people claim he's the best in the world, called Ferran Adrià.
Que en Harvard explica el método de Gaudí.
In the University of Harvard, he lectures about Gaudí's methodology.
Que consiste en aprender todo lo máximo posible,
which
conocimiento
is,
total.
Is based on total knowledge, meaning try to learn as much as possible.
Borrarlo de la mente para construir algo nuevo.
Erase it all before you build something entirely new.
Entonces Gaudí dice eso, aprendió todo lo que pudo de todo el mundo.
So he tried, Gaudí tried his very best to learn everything from everyone.
Lo borró de su mente para construir algo nuevo.
Then he basically put that aside and tried to build something new. Basically.
Pero su inconsciente siempre hizo que cogiera cosas de todo el mundo en su arquitectura.
But in the unconscious part of this thinking process, he was basically borrowing concepts from everybody he had been learning from.
Por eso encontramos también influencia de Oriente y de China en sus obras.
And that's one of the reasons why we also find Chinese and Eastern influence in his work.
¿Y cómo le llegó este conocimiento?
How did come about to know this?
Una parte de ellos le llegó a través de estos libros de Owen Jones, que era quien llevó la decoración china a Inglaterra y a toda Europa.
Well, part of it came from these books by Owen Jones, who basically was responsible for bringing Chinese ornamental styles to Europe.
Estas obras son las obras de decoración china que se editaron en Inglaterra a partir de 1850.
So these are works, decoration, interior design works, Chinese interior design works that were edited in books, appeared in books edited in England starting from 1850.
Y esta influencia naturista y geométrica de China la vemos en las obras de Gaudí.
And this influence of Chinese concept of nature and geometry can be traced back to Gaudí's work.
Nosotros en nuestro centro de investigación tenemos unas cuantas hojas de estos libros que son enormemente caros.
In their research center, they have kept some of the pages of these books that are now very, very expensive.
Porque Gaudí no era un hombre rico, solo podía comprar hojas sueltas.
So, but Gaudí wasn't a wealthy person, so he would just buy leaves, book leaves, so he couldn't buy the entire, couldn't afford the entire book.
Pero os podía consultar en la universidad.
But he was able to look at, it, I mean, to research on this in the university libraries.
Otra fuente de conocimiento de China que llegó a Gaudí.
Another Chinese source of inspiration that reached Gaudí was
fue durante la Exposición Universal de Barcelona de 1888.
During Barcelona's Universal Exhibition in 1888.
Gaudí se impresionó a ver la sección china de esta exposición.
Gaudí was very impressed after visiting the Chinese pavilion in the exhibition, the Universal Expo.
los materiales, las telas,
the materials, the clothing,
la decoración, los colores,
the decoration, the colors,
y sobre todo los, el dragón que vemos ahí de la bandera de la dinastía Qing. Que está
he was particularly impressed by the dragon that appeared in the Qing dynasty flag.
Entonces, en Occidente el dragón es el símbolo malo, es el diablo.
In the West, you may be aware that dragon is actually an evil symbol, an evil figure.
Y Gaudí, los primeros dragones de Gaudí que hacen sus obras, que hace muchos, son malos, son
In Gaudí's work, I mean, you have many, many dragons. Some of the early works featuring dragons, the dragons are usually depicted as evil figures.
Pero después poco a poco irá cambiando a ver los dragones orientales y los irá convirtiendo en seres buenos.
But gradually, after seeing examples of Chinese dragons, this motif is going to become a more benign motif.
Esto es un diseño que hizo Gaudí de una fuente para el Palacio Real de Barcelona.
This is a design of a fountain by Gaudí for the Barcelona Royal Palace.
Veremos que es un dragón chino totalmente y además es simpático.
It's a dragon, it's a Chinese dragon, and it's also a kind of figure.
En cambio, este, que es un dragón hecho ya anteriormente,
however, this is a previous work, you can see.
Vemos que es un dragón que da miedo.
It's a dragon that inspires fear.
Y este es muy curioso porque es el único dragón que está en el tejado de un edificio, que es el Gaudí.
Yeah, this is an interesting example because it is the only time a dragon was featured at the top of the roof.
No habrán visto nunca un dragón en el tejado de un edificio. Ahora lo verán más de cerca, si no,
yeah,
no lo
aprecian. Yeah, he's going to zoom in now, but you can see it's a dragon in the roof top of the building.
Curiosamente, durante 120 años nadie se dio cuenta de eso.
For 120 years, nobody realized there was actually a dragon in this building.
Hasta que hace 10 años, visitándolo con unos expertos alemanes, ellos se dieron cuenta.
10 years ago, some visitors went to this building, some people from Germany, and they realized there was a dragon hidden in that structure.
Y este es el dragón de la Casa Batlló, que podrán ver reproducido en la exposición que hacemos ahora.
This is the dragon in Casa Batlló, which is being exhibited in that exhibition.
Como pueden ver, es una genialidad, ¿no? A la derecha ven el ojo del dragón.
It's a piece of genius. On the right you can appreciate the eye of the dragon.
You can see perfecto el dragón, ¿no?
You can see the...
Naturalmente aquí aplica su famoso trencai, sus famosas piezas de cerámica.
In here you can see an application of the concept of trencadís. Trencadís is a Catalan word that is basically superimposing mosaic on a structure. So it's decorativo y al mismo tiempo estructural.
Sí.
Yeah, it's a combination of structural work and decoration. So it serves both functions.
Él utilizó siempre dos tipos de cerámica, una antigua que reciclaba.
Gaudí employed two types of ceramics. One, an old one that he would recycle.
Y una nueva, que era la cerámica vidriada de vidrio.
And a new type of ceramics, which was basically glazed.
Que la aprendió de China, que es
which he learned from China.
Donde nació hace 2500 años esta cerámica.
Where this kind of pottery was born.
Otro conocimiento de Gaudí, quizás el más importante, es de su amigo, un amigo suyo de colegio de infancia, que se llama Eduard Toda.
Another source of information in connection with China that Gaudí received came from an old school friend called Eduard Toda.
Toda fue cónsul en China en diferentes sitios.
He was consul in various Chinese cities
durante la segunda mitad del siglo XIX.
During the second half of the 19th century.
Hizo libros.
He published books.
Hizo dibujos.
He published drawings.
Y compró obras que se llevó a Barcelona.
And he would buy Chinese work of art that he would then ship back to Barcelona.
Y Gaudí tocó todos esos dibujos, todos esos libros, todas esas obras.
And Gaudí learned from all this work that.
Y naturalmente todo esto le influyó después mucho.
And influenced his work. His
aquí vemos algunos dibujos de la China que vio
China,
su amigo y que vio Gaudí su amigo.
That Gaudí learned from his friend.
Esto es un centro astronómico de en Pekín de hace 150 años.
This is a 150-year-old astronomy center in Beijing.
No hay que olvidar que mucha de la tecnología que nos llegó a Europa venía de China también.
You shouldn't forget that much of the technology that reached Europe at that time came from China.
Esto es otro de los dragones de esos que hablábamos antes, Máximos de Gaudí.
This is another kind of so-called evil dragon from Gaudí.
So de los primeros,
¿eh? From the early work.
Que hacen miedo. Debe estar mucho. Vale, aquí vemos los dibujos que hizo su amigo de cómo se hacía la cerámica en China.
These are drawings made by Gaudí's friend when he was learning about the making of pottery in China.
O sea, no solo vio la magnífica cerámica que se había producido en China durante siglos, sino vio cómo se hacía.
So he not only appreciated the final product of this porcelain that was being made in China, but he also learned about the process of making it.
Pensemos que Gaudí vive de pleno el arts and craft.
So let's not forget that Gaudí was fully immersed in arts and crafts practices.
Quiere recuperar la artesanía, el valor de la artesanía.
He was interested in bringing back the value of handmade work.
Esta otra cerámica azul y blanca.
This kind of white and blue pottery.
Esta es la que Gaudí rompe y la utiliza para sus obras.
It's used by Gaudí. He basically recycles these materials, so he basically breaks it up and then really shapes it into his work.
Pensemos que esta cerámica azul y blanca llega a España, a Europa, en el siglo XVI a través de la ruta que abre Marco Polo.
Well, let's not forget that this kind of pottery, porcelain, reaches Europe in the 16th century through the influence of Marco Polo and the trade routes opened by Marco Polo.
Que, por ejemplo, en Inglaterra se hará famosa la cerámica que llaman de huesos.
Wedgwood ceramics in England que comes from the same source.
Porque se hacía el blanco se conseguía triturando los huesos de animales.
So basically the white is achieved by smashing the animal bones.
Aquí vemos como Gaudí con trozos reciclados de cerámica antigua en el Parque Güell hace una obra de arte.
So this is a work of art by Gaudí in Parkwell where he's basically recycling and redeploying old bits and pieces of ancient porcelain and ceramics into his work.
Que es una obra de arte que ahora está declarada Patrimonio de la Humanidad.
Now this is one of the works by Gaudí that has been declared World Heritage.
Algunas de estas piezas originales las podrán ver también en la exposición de Navidad que hacemos aquí en Hong Kong.
Some of the original pieces will be shown in the Christmas exhibition in Hong Kong.
Estas son piezas de cerámica vidriada de Gaudí.
This is glazed ceramics made by Gaudí.
Esta cerámica que veremos después, él la vio gracias a los restos de la famosa torre de porcelana de Nankín.
Well, he learned this technique and, from the remains of the famous porcelain tower in Beijing.
La capital del imperio de China antes era Nankín.
In Nanjing, okay. Sorry, Nanjing, no Beijing.
Destruida a mediados del siglo XIX.
The ancient Chinese capital destroyed in the 19th century.
Y abandonada.
And abandoned.
Entonces, toda dibuja los restos de esta capital del imperio y se lleva a Barcelona restos de la de cerámicas de la
Gaudí's friend the consul the diplomat friend was basically drawing these sketches on site and then bringing the drawings and remains of these places back to Barcelona that Gaudí could then appreciate.
Esto de llevarnos cosas de los sitios no solo lo hacen los británicos, los
As you can see, the Spaniards also take away. It's not only a British practice; we also take treasures away when needed.
Okay. Uno de los restos de las tumbas imperiales de Nankín.
One of the remains from the imperial tombs in Nankín.
Que Toda vio y Gaudí vio.
That Toda and Gaudí saw.
Son estas. Este animal mítico que se llama Bixie.
Is this mythical animal called Bixie?
Yeah, es cuerpo de dragón y caparazón de tortuga.
It's a body of a dragon and a turtle shell.
Y aguanta siempre esculturas.
And it's basically supporting sculptures.
Porque la tortuga simboliza la perfección, el cosmos unido, el caos del cosmos hecho unión.
The turtle symbolizes the union between chaos and cosmos.
Y en arquitectura significa la resistencia, la tortuga son los animales que dura más, que vive más años.
And in architecture, it symbolizes resistance because the turtle is one of the animals that lives longest.
Creo que en el museo de Nanking se conservan alguna de estas esculturas.
And he thinks that in the Nanking Museum, some of these sculptures are kept.
Como veis, restaron abandonados durante mucho tiempo.
This was abandoned for decades.
Estos son fotos de otro amigo de Gaudí que viajó a China. Se llamaba Oleg Yujin.
These are photographs made by another friend of Gaudí who was traveling to China. His name was Oleg Yujin.
Esto es Nanking en 1908.
And this is Nanking in 1908.
¿Y Gaudí qué hizo? Pues lo puso en la Sagrada Familia.
So Gaudí basically inspired in these designs, basically put it in the Sagrada Familia.
Si ustedes visitan Barcelona verán, se llama, yo no sé cómo en chino, cómo es Bixi, se llama, dicen que es uno de los siete hijos del dragón.
So this mythical Chinese animal is one of the seven children of the dragon. I mean, our Chinese is not very good. We call it like Bixi, but you can see that in the Sagrada Familia in Barcelona.
También según la tradición china trae buena suerte el animal.
According to Chinese tradition, apparently this animal brings good luck.
Yo conocí al primer restaurante chino que se instaló en Barcelona hace 50 años.
He was familiar with the first Chinese restaurant opened in Barcelona 50 years ago.
Y tenían tortugas vivas.
And they had live turtles.
Pero no se las comían.
But they wouldn't eat them.
Y les pregunté por qué hacéis esto y me dijeron es que traen buena suerte.
And so he asked them, why do you have this, where do you keep these animals? Well, they bring good luck. That was the answer he got.
También Gaudí copió formas geométricas que vio en fotografías y en dibujos de China, ¿no?
So Gaudí was also inspired by some Chinese photos in his geometrical shapes that he used
to take. Esto lo vemos, es una ventana de una casa del Parque Güell.
This is a window in one of the houses in Park Güell.
Bueno, vamos a explicar quizás que Gaudí es el inventor de esta nueva arquitectura porque tenía un método técnico.
Well, he basically Gaudí managed to invent this architecture because he had a method, a technical method and approach.
Y como veía el universo en tres dimensiones,
and as he understood the universe as a tri-dimensional concept,
creó esta maqueta.
He created this model
para hacer sus formas nuevas.
To develop his new shapes.
Este invento es lo que ha inspirado posteriormente el AutoCAD.
AutoCAD is inspired in this concept, in this idea.
Y está inspirando la nueva arquitectura del futuro.
And he's also, of course, inspiring future architecture here.
Pensemos que en su época, O'Sullivan, que es el padre de los rascacielos de New York y de Chicago.
At that time, O'Sullivan, the builder of the skyscrapers in New York and Chicago.
Ya dijo hace 150 años,
said 150 years ago,
que los edificios del futuro tenían que ser los de Gaudí.
That future buildings should look like Gaudí's work.
Porque son los más aerodinámicos y los más baratos.
Because they are not only the cheapest way of building, but also the more aerodynamical.
Evidentemente, si vemos los rascacielos de Chicago o de New York, no le hicieron caso.
Well, he wasn't followed. If you look at the work at that time, the skyscrapers in New York and Chicago.
Construir cuadrado recto.
Basically, square and long squares.
Es más caro y gana más el constructor.
It's more expensive, but of course the builder makes more money that way.
Nosotros en la Universidad de Aeronáutica de Moscú hemos reproducido el invento de Gaudí en 3D.
In Moscow's Aeronautical University, they have reproduced Gaudí's invention in 3D.
Esto que parece fácil son 30 años de códigos matemáticos descifrados.
It took 30 years of mathematical coding to produce this work.
Porque estas fórmulas es para que la obra después resista.
Because these formulas are intended for the building, the structure to be resistant.
Además, estas fórmulas las han utilizado tanto en Alemania como en Rusia para temas de aeronáutica.
So, these formulas then have been applied in aeronautical engineering in Germany or in Russia.
Por ejemplo, este es un proyecto de Gaudí que nunca se llegó a hacer, que es un encargo para un rascacielos en Nueva York.
This is a project by Gaudí for a skyscraper in New York that was never carried out.
1908. Que era un edificio de 380 metros.
This was a 380 meter tall building.
Dedicado a los cinco continentes del mundo.
Dedicated to the five continents of the world.
Y que era además era hotel, museos.
It would have included a hotel, museums.
Era una obra ingente que nadie hasta ahora se ha atrevido a hacer.
It's a huge project that nobody has ever managed to materialize.
Esperemos que algún día se pueda llevar a término porque nosotros hemos desarrollado esto en con una empresa alemana de ingeniería.
So they hope, he hopes that one day someone would dare to try build this structure. They have done some preliminary work with a German engineering firm.
Naturalmente esto asustó a los promotores americanos en 1908.
But this definitely frightened the property developers in America in 1908.
Pero hoy sería una atracción mundial.
But today it would have become a well attraction.
Jan Nouvel en Barcelona o Norman Foster han hecho una pequeña imitación de este edificio.
Jan Nouvel en Barcelona, Norman Foster have been inspired in that building by Gaudí.
Okay. No quiero. Me gustaría que preguntasen después lo que quisieran, pero quiero dar esta idea de que Gaudí, que es un genio universal.
Well, he will welcome questions after this, but he would just like to stress that Gaudí, as a world genius,
inspira a cientos de temas diferentes.
He's going to inspire and to open the way for hundreds of themes.
Por eso los congresos mundiales que hemos hecho en Barcelona o en Shanghai.
So the world congress, the world conferences that they have done in Shanghai or in Barcelona.
Vienen arquitectos que estudian la parimetría.
They attract architects who are studying parametrics.
Parametrics. Vienen cocineros.
Chefs.
Vienen deportistas.
Sports people.
Vienen diseñadores.
Designers.
Vienen matemáticos.
Mathematicians.
Vienen geómetras.
Geometers.
Vienen paisajistas.
Landscape designers. Landscape architects.
O sea, da esta nueva arte, esta nueva arquitectura de oída para miles de centros de investigación y miles de personas que trabajan en
esto. This new architecture opens the way for research centers of all kinds to develop architecture.
Pero si volvemos al origen,
so if you come back to the origin,
lo único que hizo era buscar en la naturaleza las formas más
prácticas. What he was basically searching for is to look to study nature and look for the perfect shapes.
Los estudios de Gaudí, por ejemplo, sobre el pico de las aves.
The studies Gaudí carried out on the peak of the birds.
Sirvieron para diseñar el tren de alta velocidad alemán.
Were used in the design of the high-speed train in Germany.
Entonces, esto nos da idea de que estamos ante una puerta abierta al futuro.
This gives you an idea that basically Gaudí opened a door, a huge door to the future.
Y acabaré solo con nosotros somos herederos del primer gran investigador de Gaudí.
And he would like to end up by saying that they are the successors of the first Gaudí researcher ever.
Se llama Frei Otto.
Her name was Frei Otto.
Arquitecto alemán.
A German architect.
Premio Pritzker de 2015.
In Pritzker Prize in 2015.
Este arquitecto era piloto de la Luftwaffe durante la Segunda Guerra Mundial.
This was a Luftwaffe pilot during the Second World War in Germany.
Pilotaba bombardeos que bombardeaban Londres.
And he was basically driving bombers that would drop their bombs in London.
Los antiaéreos de Londres.
The batteries, the cannons shooting planes in London.
Dañaban los bombarderos porque eran muy pesados.
Basically caused a lot of damage to these planes because they were very heavy.
Y los bombardeaban por debajo.
And they would basically try to hit at the belly of the plane.
Los pilotos alemanes que conseguían volver.
And the German pilots that made it back to Germany after the
muchas
plane,
veces habían perdido las piernas del impacto. De
often they would lose their legs, the limbs, because of the impact of these shells.
Entonces los ingenieros alemanes al principio lo que hicieron fue reforzar la cabina del piloto con más acero.
So the engineers in Germany started by reinforcing the pilot's cabin with steel.
Pero claro, entonces el avión no se caía.
But then of course the plane became too heavy and it just basically flopped.
Frejotto, que era un muy joven arquitecto,
Frejotto, who was a young architect,
que había aprendido estas técnicas de Gaudí,
who had learned Gaudí's techniques.
Lo que hizo fue poner solo una plancha debajo del piloto, curva.
So he basically had only one curved,
muy fina,
very very slender curved plank below the pilot.
Y esta plancha absorbía los impactos de balas mejor que cualquier.
And that would absorb the impact of the shells better than the previous design.
Como ven, hemos vuelto a la patata Pringle.
So we are back to the Pringle chip.
So hay que volver a la naturaleza.
So it's a way of saying we have to go back to nature.
También Gaudí, nosotros tenemos un MBA.
Well, there is an MBA program in Barcelona.
En la universidad, que estudia Gaudí como fuente de economía.
That studies Gaudí as a business, from a business perspective.
Porque si conocemos a Gaudí es que es una de las brandings, de las marcas más importantes que se han creado en la historia de la
humanidad. Because it's one of the most important brands. Gaudí is one of the most important brands in human history.
Que actualmente significa un tanto por ciento importante del Producto Interior Bruto de España.
Which ends up becoming a significant percentage of the Spanish GDP.
Por el turismo que atrae.
Because it attracts huge numbers of tourists.
O sea que estamos ante un ser universal global.
So we are talking about a global human being.
Bueno, yo no quiero que ustedes, si alguien tiene preguntas y tal, mejor que conversemos un poco.
So if you have any questions, I'm very happy to answer.
Can I start with the question? You mentioned actually some of the other geniuses in the beginning, like Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci, etc. And they had patrons, you know, the Medici family, they had patrons. So did Gaudí have patronage? Was he working with lots of different clients, or did he have a certain patron that commissioned a lot of his work?
Has hablado antes de los grandes genios, Miguel Ángel,
sí.
Que tuvieron sus patrones, que sí. Básicamente los mecenas que financiaban. Sí, Gaudí tuvo varios mecenas, una persona en concreto.
Sí, tuvo dos mecenas.
Two big patrons.
Uno era un burgués que se llamaba el Conde Güell.
One was a bourgeois, a very wealthy person from Barcelona. Was a count, was Count Güell. The park, his name after him.
Los grandes genios tienen que tener alguien que esté loco con ellos, que tenga dinero.
Yeah, a great genius needs another crazy guy financially supporting him.
En el caso de Gaudí fueron el Conde Güell y la Iglesia que le encomendó.
Count Güell and the Catholic Church were the two patrons of Antoni Gaudí.
Pero Gaudí, fiel a su época.
But Gaudí, as a man of his time,
sí, fue el primero en crear una cooperativa obrera.
He was the first one in creating a kind of workers' union where basically they could self-finance themselves.
Y tiene una colonia de fábrica, una colonia fabril.
And he basically built a textile factory area.
Única en el mundo hace 150 años.
Unique in the world where the workers were housed.
Porque tenía escuela para niños y para niñas.
He had schools for children.
Hospital.
Hospital.
Campo de deportes.
Sports fields.
Casino.
Casino.
Teatro.
Casino in this case means a club.
Yeah,
it's not exactly for gambling. It's a club for.
Tenía teatro.
A theater.
Y le daba a los obreros posibilidades que ahora son normales, probablemente no.
And so basically the workers had all these benefits.
Los ayudaba cuando estaban enfermos.
He was able to help with the healthcare of the.
Cuando eran viejos y no servían para trabajar.
When they were elderly and they couldn't work any longer.
O sea que aunque tuviera unos mecenas ricos de la época, sus principios eran obreros.
So even though he had very very wealthy patrons behind him, he was a very socially conscious person.
También en eso fue pionero porque podríamos decir que creó el beneficio social.
He was a pioneer also in that respect. He was very much concerned with social welfare and he developed it in life, in his works.
Porque los trabajos de él se lo agradecían.
And the workers, of course, were very appreciative of that.
Y trabajaban para ellos.
And would work for him wholeheartedly.
Tanto es así que durante la Segunda Guerra, la Guerra Civil Española,
so much so that during the Spanish Civil War,
el mecenas de Gaudí huyó a Inglaterra.
Gaudí's patron had to run away, had to escape to England.
Cuando volvió a España después de la guerra,
and when he returned to Spain after the war,
los obreros anarquistas,
the anarchist workers,
le dijeron, ¿por qué has huido?
They asked him, why did you escape? Why did you run away?
Porque en España se mataba a todos
los you are killing all the wealthy guys right now in Spain.
Sí, pero a ti no te hubiésemos matado porque te queríamos.
But we wouldn't have killed you because we really loved you. That's what they said to me.
I want to introduce our second speaker, Maria Massagay. She's the managing director of the Gaudí Exhibition Center. She literally just landed, just arrived. I think both of them just arrived. So we really appreciate you just telling a little bit about the Gaudí Exhibition Center.
Thank you for your welcome. Thank you, everybody, for assisting this conference, and thank you for inviting us to Hong Kong and to the university. Barcelona owns a lot of main masterpieces of Gaudí, so I hope you have the chance to visit Barcelona if you have already visited. But we thought that there was a lack of information regarding his person, because every building focuses a lot of themselves, obviously. So we find this opportunity to set up the new Gaudí Museum in Barcelona, focusing on the person, on why he did what he did, which were his influences, where he learned from, and why he developed himself as he did. So these main questions, we working together with Professor Figuerola and the Gaudí Research Institute, we worked to set up a big exhibition located in the city center, as you could see in the photo. The museum, it's located in the Gothic Quarter of Barcelona, next to the cathedral. The building is for the 14th and 15th century, so we did a big removal inside. So we present a four-part exhibition focusing on influences, focusing on main subjects important for him, like light, geometry, tradition, science, and also the time where he was living, like the Industrial Revolution in Catalonia. Then we focus in some of his masterpieces like Sagrada Familia, Baldwin, Colonia Wayne, and finally we talk about his legacy, how contemporary architects from nowadays are inspired by him. So this, all this together, we have original documents, we have models, tools, drawings, and we thought that it was important to find a technological partner to set up exhibition that was also attractive for the visitors, because nowadays I really think that new technologies give us a chance to approach more to the public, because usually some people would thought that visiting a museum could be quite boring, and we want to change this mind, and that's why we work nowadays with Samsung. We make an audio guide that goes with you all around the exhibition that was written by a dramaturg together with the curator. So we create a storytelling with words from Gaudí that we know that he said, that all are compiled in a book. So we want to give the visitor a chance to listen to the voice of this genius. Also, we create new video productions, we have a virtual reality experience, and we really think that visitors have this experience together with the knowledge and technology, and that's why the feedback is really good. So we really encourage yourself to come and visit this piece of exhibition in Telford Plaza, talking. We focus on China, on Gavi and China, as the professor for sure explained to you. But we hope here you could taste a little bit about him and about the museum, and then you run to Barcelona to visit our museum.
Yes. We have more collaborations with Chinese university for sure, but we can arrange some exchange program.
Sure, yeah. For sure.
So, any Q&A from the students?
Yes.